Welcome to New Hope. I want you to be encouraged tonight. We're facing a lot of issues, social unrest, this pandemic, and maybe even some personal struggles. But I think that that's why we come to worship. We come to worship to not only be blessed in the presence of God, we come to worship so that we can be uplifted, that we can be renewed. And I sure pray that this service will do that for you so that we can continue to fight the good fight in the name of Jesus Christ. Our move is complete. We are now operating out of our new church home in Anaheim. You'll hear more about that during announcements, but I am so excited. I'll be bringing you pictures of the construction, pictures of new things going up. We just praise God for this opportunity, and it's going to be good. Tonight, we have some special friends who are bringing us music. We also have our choir, which is always on fire for the Lord. Children will be speaking, greetings from around the way, and of course, I'm bringing a word too. I pray that you'll feel the joy of our service, and that it will reassure you and give you everything you need to make it through the next week. May God bless you as we prepare our hearts and our minds to worship in spirit and in truth.
Every word of worship, one on the Lord, every breath. Oliver, bringing you greetings from our household to yours. I miss you. I miss your hugs. I miss your faces. I miss your smiles. I miss holding hands with you. I miss praying with you. I miss all the wonderful things that we do here at New Hope Presbyterian Church, where you all matter. You matter, I matter, everybody matters. I can't wait for this pandemic to be over so I can rush up to you and hug you and let you know how much I missed you. Again, I miss you, I miss you, I miss you. Take care, New Hope family. Be well, stay healthy, and don't forget to wash your hands. Amen.
New Hope to me is a place where you matter. It's a place of joy, a place of happiness, as well as a place of feeling as a family. And I'm so grateful to all that have helped in building and making New Hope what it is today, a place where you actually feel as though you are family. I'm so grateful and thankful for having this opportunity to share with you, as well as to be able to express my thanks for us moving forward to our new location. Oh, I can't wait. It's going to be great when we can get together again to see and be with everyone in fellowship and hear the music and hear a great word that will keep us going week to week, day by day. These are the things for me that makes New Hope what it is, truly a place where you matter. I love you, I miss you, can't wait to see you.
Not a second of another minute, not an hour of another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. I need you now, I need you now, I need you now, I need you now. Not another second or another minute, not an hour of another day, but Lord, I need you right away. If I never needed you before, to show up and restore all of the faith that I let slip while I was yet searching the world for more of the truest friend. I have in need. You're my best friend, I know indeed. I stretch my hands to thee. Come rescue me, I need you right away. The agony of being alone, fear of doing things on my own, tests and trials that come to make me strong. The feelings of guilt, hurt, shame, and defeat, the weight of trials that beat upon me. But to know, Lord, that in you I've got victory. I need you now, Lord, I need you now. I need you right now, right now, right now. I need you now. Not another second, not another minute, not another night. Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, please make a way. Oh Lord, oh Lord.
It's your deacon,
Jimmy Jones, also known as DJ Jimmy Jams. Hey, you guys, I'm at work. I have to transport a couple of doctors and nurses over to UCLA Medical Center. This is our UCLA commuter bus. They get to rest before they get to work. But before I do that, I would like to pray with you. Let's bow our heads. Merciful God, we come to you seeking your grace, peace, and protection for our friends, families, and ourselves. Heal our hearts and give us assurance as we come through the coronavirus. Help those who are hungry and those who are facing financial problems. Bless our nation and guide our leaders in the decisions that they make. Heal our land and our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. A to the man. New Hope, I miss you and I love you. Take care.
Hello, church family. I would like to share Scripture Isaiah 56, verse 1 and 2. Listen to the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord, maintain justice and do what is right, for soon my salvation will come and my deliverance be revealed. Happy is the mortal who does this, the one who holds it fast, who keeps the Sabbath, not profaning it, and refrains from doing any evil. This is the word of God for the people of God.
We're also thankful for the reading of God's word. And I pray that God's word encourages us and gives us hope during this time of uncertainty while we're in this pandemic. We need things that remind us, a word that reminds us that the feast table of God, the fellowship table, belongs to all of us. And speaking of tables, my dining room table seats 8 people, but I can open up the space because I have these leaves that expands and allows me to include more people. I say that my table serves as a symbol of how God wants the church to be. God has an expectation that we will extend ourselves to receive others and to share in Christ's love. because one day the glory will be ours. And when I look at the text in Isaiah, it looks like God has put Israel on notice about this very thing, that the table of grace and deliverance and glory has a greater victory because it's expanded and it shall include room for the foreigner, for the stranger, for the outsider to witness and rejoice in the establishment of a new glory and a new kingdom to come. It states this in verse 6 through 8 of Isaiah 56. And the foreigners who join themselves to the Lord, who hold fast to my covenant, these I will bring to my holy mountain and make them joyful in my house of prayer. Thus says the Lord God, who gathers the outcasts of Israel. I will gather others to them besides those who have already gathered. And we are reaffirmed in this message through Psalm 67. Psalm 67 extends the table of God's community to all nations, to all peoples, to the very ends of the earth. So what's the problem? This is all great, isn't it? Well, the problem is it's difficult to do. It's hard to actualize because everybody's not invited to the table. Some people just don't get the invitation at all. It makes me think about the Canaanite woman in Matthew 15. She was an outsider who asked Jesus to heal her daughter. And he looked at her after she was annoying to the disciples and he said, I'm here for the house of Israel. I am not giving crumbs to a dog like you. Oh, I wish she had said to her, well, you can go ahead and help your people, but guess what? I'm God's people too. But she came equipped anyway. She came equipped with a prophetic hope and an imagining that she was included. She brought with her the glory of the psalmist who proclaimed that the table of God's community is expanded to all nations and to all people and to the very ends of the earth. That's why she approached Jesus in the first place. That's why the church must keep adding new leaves to our fellowship table. I wish she had said to Jesus, all right, well, you just tell the tax collector to slide down a seat. Go ahead and ask that prostitute that you saved to pass the salt. Because number one, I belong here. My soul needs to be seasoned in your salvation. Number two, I am included, and your call is as expansive as your Father's grace is, and your Father's grace goes to the ends of the earth. And number three, my daughter is sick, and we need your healing. Now, she didn't say that, but she did say, Messiah, Holy One of Israel, heal my child. Be about your Father's business, because I will take the crumbs that you would give a dog and I will use them to the glory of God. Jesus looked beyond her outsider status, her poverty, her differences, and he saw her inclusive praise. He saw her rich expectation. My grandmother used to sing a song and it was said, fix it, Jesus, fix it like you said you would. And she was in a fix it, Jesus, fix it like you said you would moment with Jesus in this moment. This woman wasn't backing down. She needed him to fix it. In her blog, Journey with Jesus, Debbie Thomas says that her response was just brilliant, not least because it cuts to the very heart of Jesus's boundary-breaking, taboo-busting, division-destroying ministry of table fellowship. The table is precisely where Jesus shows the world who God is, as if to say, Lord, where's my good news? Lord, where's my place at the table? When will your goodness be good enough for me and good enough for my daughter? Oh boy, she's speaking truth to power. As a woman, as a mother, as a sister, as a Canaanite, as a believer. When will your goodness heal the land for all? When will your goodness hug on my faith and shake hands with my hope? When will your goodness affirm that I am not forgotten? And God knows my name. God knows my name. Some call me poor. God knows my name. I am a woman. God knows my name. I'm called an outsider. God knows my name. I am a fighter. God knows my name. I am known as tired. God knows my name. I am quite weary. God knows my name. I am a daughter of the darkness of slavery, and God still knows my name, and he made a promise to me that his table of grace is big enough, thick enough, solid enough to receive a sinner like myself. And this is the lesson to the church, that the scope of its hope and faith and mission must dare to break boundaries of traditions and behaviors and attitudes and fears and doubts and prejudices and racism that would limit the grace of God and the love of Jesus Christ. Oh yeah, the table has to be expanded. The table must be expanded so that all of God's people are treated with justice and kindness, and that all of God's people can rejoice in building each other up instead of judging each other down. We're facing some difficult days ahead, and in these uncertain moments, we desperately need the good news of Jesus Christ in order to drive the mission of faith and service and inclusiveness forward. We need to review a prophetic text like Isaiah 56 in order to apply the sweet nectar of God's hope, plan, promise, vision during these days of social and political unrest, during these days of COVID-19, during these days when the flu is about to start coming too. During these days, we need a healing, and the good news is crucial for helping us to get through. The glory of God is not preserved for the privileged, and it is not lost on the outsider. So expand the table and be persistent in the pursuit of justice. Isaiah 56:1 says, maintain justice and keep doing what is right, for my salvation is close at hand and my righteousness will soon be revealed. The glory of the Lord is coming. Trust in God's grace, because the glory of the Lord is not far away. Know that Jesus hears and knows. Jesus' salvation is truly our greatest reward, even when he is set on the track to fulfill his purpose and mission by a Canaanite woman who says, I belong to, I'll take your crumbs and I'll take them to the glory of God. God will gather others together besides those already gathered and say, my house shall be a house of prayer for all people. May the church be on notice and also be encouraged in its challenge to expand its leaves and to follow the will of God. Expand our leaves and share the glory of God with those who are hurting. Expand our leaves and share the glory of God with those who still reel from George Floyd's death. Expand those leaves and be with those who believe in what was said about stirring up some good trouble by our brother John Lewis. Believe and know that God sits on the throne, and Jesus Christ set out on a mission in which each and every one of us, Jews, Gentiles, everybody was included in the mission of salvation. Believe and know that one day when the glory comes, it will be us. It will be ours. Hallelujah, praise the Lord. One day, when the war is won, it will be us. When all God's children get together, what a time, what a time, what a time. We can do this. Scoot over. I want to sit down too. Scoot over. You got a neighbor down the street that deserves to be here. Scoot over. Let the table of the Lord be of one fellowship and unity in spirit, that we may praise God and know that the glory of the Lord is upon us. God bless you. Pray for one another. And we'll see you next week.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure. We will be sure. Oh, glory. One day, when the glory comes, it'll be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory. When the glory comes, it'll be ours, it'll be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure.
Oh, hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Every day women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skins become blessings.
Well, the battle is not over. The victory is won. We will fight on to the finish. And when it's all done, we'll cry glory. Oh, glory. Oh, glory.
Us. Freedom is like religion to us.
When the battle is over,
justice is just a position to us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. Truant living, living in us. Resistant is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walk through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down and we stand up. Shots me on the ground, the camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop and we ran up.
We'll cry glory when the victory is won. When the battle is done, we'll cry glory. Oh, oh, we'll cry glory. We'll cry for glory.
We stand at the feast table of hope. In gathering as we are, we know that we are not forgotten, we are not abandoned because of the love that God has for us through Jesus Christ. Matthew 11:28 says, "Come to me, all who are weary, and I will give you rest." This is exactly why we come to this communion table together, to be unified in the assurance of God's love. Let us pray together. Merciful God, we thank you for this opportunity to share in your love and to share in what it means to be a part of the sacrifice that Jesus Christ took on for our lives. We thank you, Lord, that sin was taken away and replaced by unity and peace and love. Help us in taking communion together tonight to remember your love, your witness, and your intention for the world to be drawn to Christ. Amen. On the night of his arrest, Jesus was with his disciples, and he took bread and he broke it, saying, "This is my body, broken for you for the forgiveness of sins." And likewise, he took the cup and he poured it, saying, "This is the new covenant spilled in my blood." Every time you take this cup and you take this bread, you do this in remembrance of me. Friends, let us share in the joy and the celebration of communion. Reggie is going to come and help us with communion for those of you who received pods. He's going to show you how to open them. Take the top off. The body of Christ broken for you. Peel away the bottom layer. The blood of our Lord and Savior poured out for you. May God continue to bless you and keep you. May the light of his love shine upon you. We pray that you're encouraged tonight.
Hi, it's Mike Randall. I have the best job in the world. I get to see the most amazing creativity every single day at my shop. But I want to talk about New Hope's creativity. New Hope's creativity is on a totally different level. New Hope creates an atmosphere that fosters love and kindness and acceptance, and empathy, and forgiveness, truth, and generosity, on and on, so much more. So I want to urge you to donate. Donate what you can, and when you can, and as often as you can. There are three ways you can do that. The easiest way is online, if you're inclined, or you can mail it to the new P.O. Box in Anaheim, or call the office and they'll help you. Make the world a better place. Thanks.
Good evening, New Hope family and friends. It's me bringing you a weekly church announcements. Phase one has begun at New Hope and the walls are coming down just like Jericho. We thank you so much to all of our New Hope family, New Hope partners, and New Hope friends who who continue to pray for us and support us during this time of renovation. And God has continued to bless us even more. California Arts Council has granted us funds to support our string studio for our youth, and the Presbyterian Church USA Missions Agency has granted us funds to support our women's ministry. We should give God all the praise and glory and nothing but gratefulness and gratitude for all that He is doing to bless New Hope during this time and season. On Tuesday nights, join us at 7 p.m. for our Holy Hangouts. Come join us, relate with us, laugh with us, and let us get to know you better. Share something unknown that we don't know about you that you think we should know, and let us share ourselves with you. It's a wonderful time of fellowship, and we look forward to seeing you on Tuesday nights on Zoom virtually at 7 p.m. Also on Thursdays, as you know, you should know, I tell you every week, we have our prayer walks at 6:30 p.m. Meet us at the cross. All you have to do is show up socially distanced, in a mask, and don't forget your tennis shoes, and be ready to walk and pray and give God praise and glory in the evening. It's fall now, the weather is beautiful, and we are so looking forward to having more people come out and join us for these prayer walks. I'm looking to see you there this week. So remember to subscribe and like us. I gave you some time last week, so you should have plenty of practice. Tell all your friends, your family, and strangers about New Hope's virtual service on Saturdays at 5 p.m. on our New Hope Presbyterian Church channel. We should be growing in numbers because God is getting ready to do something wonderful at New Hope, and you should want everyone you know to be a part of it. I know I do. God bless you and have a wonderful week.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh.